in all our informal settlements, the average size of a house in Mumbai is about between 200 to 400 square feet. Most of the people end up going to public toilets. With the volume of people who are there now, there isn't enough water. These all used to be pay-and-use toilets, the toilets that were set up by the municipality, constructed by them. They were pay-and-use. So you paid a small charge for using. In return, you got soap and the things were cleaned. Now the government has said you can't charge them, and of course people can't pay. But now where is all the cleaning stuff and payment for electricity and water? Where is it going to come from? No answers. What we are looking at is that every development deficit, the exclusionary practices, the inadequate management of infrastructure for the poor in all our cities is coming back to become a double burden on the poor, but also putting the cities themselves into a quandary of what to do, because all our cities are dependent on national and state subsidies. They don't, we all love to rave and rant about the cities, but the fact is that, they don't have the protocols and the procedures to address the issues of informal settlements. So now we've got permits for our central committee to go and drop the food packets and the soap and whatever else to the edge of the settlement, and then people pick it up and then they leave it outside everybody's homes. Now, this is the kind of infrastructure that should be there across all neighborhoods. Because tomorrow, if there are floods, what are we going to do? We're going to have the same problem. Local people will have to take action. And we haven't invested in making local communities make representations on what they want. So one of the really interesting things that the community networks have suggested to me to see if we could get resources for is for us to be given the money to look at how we could do what they call lockdown slum style, you know. I think for me, the most important contribution that global institutions can do is to transform the process by which solutions are looked at. At the moment, they're too highfalutin, they don't involve different constituencies, and they don't, as a result, they don't reach where they should reach. So we can't go back to everything as it was before COVID. So we've got to figure out what are the things that we are learning, what are the new insights it's giving us. And basically what it's telling us is that grassroots organizations, and I'm not saying only SDI and whoever we are, but all local networks have to be recognized, have to be validated, have to be communicated with, because only through that circulation of information and dialogue will there be an ability to address the unknown.